Hello and welcome back. Today we're going through more world coins that have kindly been sent into my PO box. So thank you to everyone that has sent coins kindly into the PO box. I'm going to be keeping these world coin hunts going for what seems to be the next decade to try and catch up on the backlog coins that have been sent in. So big thank you. As usual, we'll look at my New Mister front page. New Mister is the website I use to log my coin collection. I get all the details for the annotations of these videos from New Mister. If you haven't used it before, it's free to use. I'm not sponsored or incentivized to send you there. I've been using it for many years and I'd highly recommend you give it a go. But let's look at some coins now. So we're going to pick off where we left off with coins from Keith. We start with Bermuda. 1 cent, got a little pig on it, 1997. Very cool. I do like coins with animals on, so that's a plus. Trinidad and Tobago, 1999. Oh, another little animal. It's a bird of some description. 1 cent. I must admit, I'm not a twitcher, so I couldn't even tell you what kind of bird that is, but that's another cool little coin, isn't it? This is a teeny tiny. This is from Israel. Okay. Cool little palm tree on it. What nomination would that be? It's a very good question. The problem with Israeli coins is that they have changed denominations quite a few times. And unless it says what the denomination is, I've got no idea. It is a little aluminium coin. So, there we go. That's one of the joys of these videos when I get to do the editing. I try and learn a little bit, but my brain doesn't retain information all that well. Right. Okay, we've got Sanskrit-y kind of writing. Oh. I kind of know this. Is it a Poisha? Poisha? The denomination? Where is this from? Oh, that's so frustrating. I think I know this, but I can't quite wrap my head around it. That's a pause on that one. Well, not pause, but maybe I'll come up with what it is before the end of the video, but that has somewhat bamboozled me. Right, we've got one somethings. This one as well. Oh, it says Georgia on it. Thank goodness for that. I can't have two in a row where I'm trying to rack my brains. My head will explode. 1993, that looks like. It's a very small little coin. One, I have no idea what the denomination is in Georgia. But there we go. Crumbs, these are testing me, aren't they? Okay, what have we got here? We have got a Food and Agricultural Organization coin. A very cool design, I like that. It is from, oh, Turkey. 50,000 lira from 1999. Obviously not 50,000 Turkish lira as it is today. I can't remember what the word is. They basically redesignated their currency. They knocked off a couple of zeros. Did it knock off the three zeros? So whatever it is, they remapped the currency because it was massively inflated, which happened a few times around the world, different currencies. That's a very shiny 5 centavos. Centavos? Like South American? El Salvador. Now I always struggle with what's Central and what's South America, but this that neck of the woods. 1994. Very nice quality one, isn't it? That was a UK coin, given the sort of mirror finish fields and the frosting on the design. I said it looks like a formerly proof coin, but I'm not 100% sure on coins from El Salvador, not part of the world I got many coins from. We are in Singapore now, 1994. Crumbs, this is a far and widespread bunch of coins. 1 cent. Very nice. Lots of exciting countries. 1 franc. Ooh. That's a very pretty design. I like that little, is it a feather or like is it like a fern? I can't tell if it's a leaf or a feather, but it's very pretty. Where's this from then? Republic de Guinea. Oh, Guinea, French Guinea. 1985, wow. A lot of dinky little coins, aren't there? Wonderful stuff. And I like the colour of that as well, it's sort of brassy gold. 1992, Romanian, 5 lei. I don't know how you pronounce that, but might be lei, so you'll have to take my pronunciation with a grain of salt. I try my best. Alright, we've got a coat of arms there. 1976. That's Icelandic. 1 krona. I did think sort of Scandinavian, that sort of cross. Lots of Scandinavian countries have that sort of cross in different colours. But I didn't dare say anything in case I was wrong. Especially after that start I've had with a couple of countries I can't figure out. Oh, what's this? 20 somethings. 1994. I don't have the faintest idea. We've got eagles. No, it's an eagle and a leopard. An eagle and a leopard. Wow. Can we gain anything else from that crest? Spot anything there? I don't even recognise the text. 2094. Wow. Okay, well, there we go. I've got the faintest idea, but if I've got absolutely no idea, maybe that's a new country that I've not seen before. Oh, lovely brassy gold colour. That's a very intricate design as well. That's very cool. Guyana. 1 cent. 1979. Again. That's a nice coin too. Wow, well. I'm getting well and truly stumped by a number of these coins today. Right, another Food and Agricultural Organization coin from the year 2000. Republic de... Oh, Panama. Okay. Very nice. In Panama, not a part of the world I got many coins from. But, and again, a very crisp, lovely design, isn't it? 1 centesimo. It was aluminium as well. Right, 1 centavo, 1998. Argentinian. I know I mentioned a few times, but they're just circular coins, but they've got this interesting border. I think that really makes it look sort of makes it look a little bit more interesting than just a circular coin. Tanzania, 1989. 50 centi. A little rabbit on it. Might be a hare. I don't know the difference between a rabbit and a hare, I must admit, but it's probably one or the other. Ooh, 1994, Banco Central de Nicaragua. Ooh, Nicaragua. Very cool. Triangle in it. Again, I don't know if that's a country I actually already have any coins from. Lovely design, isn't it? We've got lots of very little coins then, so far. Dear, where's this from? Right, I can see a sickle and hammer. Oh, that doesn't really help. 10 somethings, 1980. A sickle and a hammer. 1980. Hmm. Sickle and hammer. So it's somewhere communist in the 80s. With this sort of writing, it sort of reminds me of sort of Thai script. So I don't think they're not communists in Thailand, they've got a monarchy there. Could be, surely 1980, could be Vietnam maybe? I don't know. Not the faintest idea. I mean, I tried to do a bit of working that one out, but these are proving to be quite perplexing. There's still a whole pile of them as well. Right, we've got three lions, 1998. Esti, so this is Estonian, 10 centi. Hmm. Yeah, so we'll do a few more, there's still like so plenty more here, so we'll return to these at some point. This is from Uganda, 5 shillings, it looks like a tiny little 50 pence coin, that's really cute. 1987. I do really like that one. So it's like someone has shrunk a 50p. Another aluminium one. Okay, Arabic writing on this one. Right, one somethings. Ah! Got the eagle. Come on, Christopher, we know this. I think I've seen that eagle before. I think the eagle with the stars on its chest is Libya. But without the stars... the Egypt? Oh, I don't know. I don't think that's right. I'm going to kick myself. I'm going to kick myself the moment I bring this up to when I'm editing. Unbelievable. Right. One more. Crumbs, this has been the hardest world coin hunt we've done in ages. Look at that! This cute little owl. Where's this from? Slovenia. 20-somethings, whatever the denomination in Slovenia was or is. 1993. I really like that. That's such a minimalistic design. Is it an owl or is it a bat? I think it is an owl, isn't it? Yeah, look at those eyes. I was looking at the wings thinking, ooh, is that an owl? Wow, well, they've been some incredible cons. I'm quite excited to do the editing on this and find out quite where I am right and wrong. Well, there we go. That was a lot of fun going through these coins. In terms of favourite, it's got to be that last one, the one with the little owl on it. I think that's an absolutely stunning design. But do let me know in the comments what your favourite coin from today's video is. And if you knew some of the countries I didn't know, do let me know in the comments how you figured it out. Because I'm a little bit embarrassed at how many coins tripped me up today. But that's the way it is with numismatics. It's such a wide field. It'd be impossible to know everything about every coin issued in any country at any time. We live and we learn, so plenty to add to my banks of knowledge. I immediately forget moments after having edited the video, but I'll try and retain it. But been very, very fun going through these. So links as usual are in the description of this video to my coin collecting Discord server. If you want to come over and join me over there, there's also links to my Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, PO Box address, and the Britannia Coin Company, who I work for making videos for them. So please do check that channel out as well. All it leaves me to do now, though, is thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you next time for more coins. Bye.